गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। तो आई थिंक आई एम ऑडिबल।
यस
ओके फाइन। ओके सो अ वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू हैव अ डिस्कशन ऑफ मशीन डेटा साइंस टॉपिक। एक्चुअली ऑलमोस्ट व्हाट एवर इन द सिलेबस, एक्चुअली फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वुड लाइक टू शो यू पीपल अबाउट द सिलेबस। मैंने So first of all, whatever in the syllabuses actually that the according to JUP, the module 1, module 2, and module 3, and module 4. There are four modules were given, right? So module 1, 2, and module 3 that was completed, and means almost we have discussion on each and every topic. Okay, and in the set of module 4, that is a particularly practical based. How to set up a Python, how to install Anaconda, what are the things, what are the packages in the Anaconda or Python, okay, and how to use the Matplotlib as to for the data visualization. These type of things are given, and that we have done some of these topics in our labs, okay, but still we are going to do some of more topics in the lab, right? So the topics of discussion, whatever the things have given as the theoretical, actually, I mean the module 1, 2, and 3 that have been completed almost, okay. But today I am going to show you some more things and discuss some more things about the data science and some of the topics, okay. So we have discussed about the network and all of this. Means I am talking about this particular portion of clustering, regression, PCA, this type of particular, right? So in one of my last class, I have remembered that I have trying to show you some neurons about that, how to do, how the things actually hidden layers, this type of topics, input layer, output layers. Okay. So I will have more discussion on that particular topic today, right? So that is here we are starting from that one of the thing that is in our data science, or in more precisely we can say that is present in our machine learning actually, right? So we have a topic called Maclopitz neuron. The name is given as Maclopitz neuron. Okay, so first of all, forget about the Maclopitz. Just focus on the neuron. Okay, just focus on the particular topic name, that is neuron. So what a neuron is? If I ask that what a neuron is, so what will be the answer? That neuron means that a biological means component we can. The neuron is a biological component that is present in our body. Means, and what is the purpose of neuron? That to follow or to we if we have a given of input of some particular things that will be flow into our body, and then we have a certain response on that particular input whatever we are getting, right? So as this data science or machine learning, whatever the topics are, is all based on this particular scenario, okay, a biological neuron. And similar to that, we are trying to, the scientists, the data scientists are trying to develop something that will be similar to a human body, or similarly kind of responses we can actually predict, right? So Maclopitz neuron is one of those type, but those type of topic. Here we can see in the diagram that a particular in one, in two, in n, this type of things is named there. So this in one, in two, up to dot dot in n, it is the given is input. So a multiple input is coming, right? And in the second last part, we can see that there is a out, means a output part is there. So we are getting a multiple input, and respective of that particular multiple input, we have certain output also, right? So multiple input has some output is present there. Beside in the circle, now topic is coming in the circle, we have some summation and some threshold value. Summation and some threshold value. So if we're talking, so this threshold have some logic in it. There are some threshold logic unit actually present. So a large number of multiple inputs are coming and that will be accumulated having a synopsis, and then it will be, if it is following some particular threshold logic, then we can say that it will reach up to that particular threshold limit. It will reach up to that particular threshold limit, and then we can have some particular output respective to that, right? So we can say that a set of synopsis, we can say that a set of synopsis is present here, and that is bringing some activation from the neuron. So if we are considering that if, as a body, as a human body, then what we can see that we can have multiple input at the same time. And depending on this input, our body will particularly react on that. So a similar kind of a set of synapses are the connections that have been coming, bringing some activation from other neurons. And the processing unit, So the processing unit sums the input. So whatever the inputs are coming in this particular scenario, right, in one, in two. Whatever the things are coming from in one, in two, in n to this particular moment or particular point, right? So it will sums all the input. So it will gather and accumulates all the input and then applies the nonlinear activation function. So such as threshold function I am talking about. So a threshold function of any type of nonlinear activation function will be there, such as the quashing, transfer, threshold function. Basically, in most of the cases, we use this threshold function. Okay, so a threshold function is applied here. And then if the input, if the summation of all this particular input reaches up to that particular point, then we can have a particular output here. So a very basic or simple, we are talking, means when I'm discussing that, it is like very simple things, but in reality, it is not actually like that. So it is very tough to implement actually, but in theoretically, it is quite easy to discuss an explanation on that. So multiple inputs are coming here, summation of that particular, all the multiple inputs, and then a threshold or activation function is there. And respective to that, we are getting some particular output in that particular scenario. So as we are talking that there is some nonlinear activation function is given. Nonlinear activation function, such as the squashing, transfer, threshold function, whatever the things are. So it is the example that what can be our nonlinear activation functions. So it is a transfer function. Okay. So a threshold or sine function, that is SGNX, is defined by if X, the value of X is greater than equal to zero, so the value will be one. So, and if X is less than equal to zero, then the value will be zero. Now, how to calculate this X greater than X, the value of X is greater than equal to zero, or the value of X is less than equal to zero. Here, the value of X is coming from this particular multiple inputs. So the X means that the total summation of all the inputs, If the value of X, if the summation of all the inputs is equal to X and the value of X is greater than equals to zero, then we can say it is it will be the value of one. And if it is less than equal to zero, then it will be a zero. So this is the simple functions calling. So we have done the functions in mathematics also. So these are the basic things of the function, right? So then of this McLopitz neuron function we are talking about, so a similar thing is actually implemented here. That output is the sigma function is present here, then the summation of all the inputs, that I equal to one to less than n minus theta. So this theta is the neuron's activation threshold. So where at some particular stage, activation is needed. Okay, means if we cannot activate, then a value or the output will not be generated. So activation is particularly needed in that particular cases. So activation means if the value of all the summation reaches up to that particular point, then the value will be activated. Then it will be activated. Okay, so as I said, this McLopitz neuron or whatever we are talking about in the case of data science and all of this, it is similar kind of a biological neurons, how it is actually happening. It is a concept of that particular biological neurons implemented or trying to be implemented in the case of McLopitz neuron. So as I said that if the output will be one when the value of the sigma function is greater than equal to zero, or where the value has been as theta. So summation of all the inputs, then if it is greater than zero or theta, then the output will be one. And if it's less than equals to zero or theta, then the value equal will be zero, right? So a similar simple described have been given here. Okay, so here x1 x1 x2 x3 these are our inputs. Okay, y is our output. So x1 x2 x3 is our input and y is our output. Now here two thing is given, one is t, another one is w1 w2 and w3, right? So t, what is this particular t? T means the threshold. Here the 3 means the threshold value up if which can be considered as the limit. If the value is limiting to the threshold or greater than the threshold value, then it will be activated, otherwise it will not be activated. Means if the value is greater than threshold value or limits the reaches to the threshold value, then the value will be 1, and if it is not, then it will be 0. Now what this w, what is this particular w? Okay, first of all, one I'm trying to say that whatever I'm discussing today, it is not actually present in your syllabuses, okay? Because all the syllabuses is almost finished up, so I am trying to give you some more interaction or more description about this particular data set. Means whatever the things have been given, that is the basic. So more precisely, we need to know something, that what are the things actually behind this. So why are we studying, why actually we are learning this data science? So this W1, W2 or W3 is called the weightage value. It's called the weightage value. So W1, W2, W3 is called the weightage value of respective of every particular input. So if X1 having an input, so it has some value, and respective to that of X1, there will be a weightage value of W1. There will be a weightage value of W1. Similar kind of for W2, it will be X2, and W3 for to X3. Similarly, it can be up to N, XN and WN. So summation of all this, so multiplication of x1 w1 plus x2 w2 plus x3 w3, if all this value reaches up to the threshold value or greater than up to this threshold value t, then the value of y will be 1, otherwise it will be 0. I repeat that if the value, if the summation means x1 w1 x1 into w1 plus x2 into w2 plus x3 into w3 reaches up to the threshold limit that greater than equal to t, then it will be activated and the value of y will be 1. The value of y will be 1. Otherwise, the value of y will be 0. Otherwise, the value of y will be 0. So taking to that particular threshold, if it is the reaches to the threshold value, then the value will be 1. Otherwise, it will be 0. Otherwise, it will be 0. Okay. So by using this McLuhan's neuron, means by using this particular logic of X1, W1, all of this particular, we can implement our basic gates also. We can implement our basic gates also. Basic gates means OR gate, AND gate, NOR gate, NOT gate, whatever the gates we have studied in the semester 2 and 3 for the logical units, logical gates actually, we can also implement that. We can also implement that. Okay. So an OR gate, we can say that value of it is a logic truth table of an OR gate. So value of x1, x2 is given. So it will be the input 0, x1 is 0, x2 is 0. Then the value of y will be 0. If x1 is 0 and x2 will be 1, the value of y will be 1. So what is an OR gate? Can anyone tell me that what is an OR gate or what is the logic of an OR gate? What is the means what is OR gate? If I'm talking about OR gate, so what is the OR gate? So in OR gate, we can say that suppose two particular values are there. Okay, one is high value, one is low value. High value will be considered 1 and low value will be considered as 0. So if one of the input in OR gate is high, then the output will be high. If one of the inputs in the OR gate is high, then the output will also be high. If all the inputs are low, then the output will be low. Otherwise, if any one of the input is high, then the output will be high. So similar to that, the truth table is very easy. The 0 and 0 in both the cases, in both the inputs x1 and x2, it will be low value, then the output will be low, and rest of the cases the value will be 1, because x1 is 0 and x2 is a high value, so the output will also be a high value. So this is a basic OR gate truth table, and basic OR gate is truth table. So implementation of these logical gates using the McLuhan's neuron. implementation of this particular thing. So logic functions or is actually described. So we can see that x1 and x0, x1 and x2. So x0 is by default an input. Okay. So we were considering only x1 and x2, and we need to implement this. So means if the value of x1 is 0 and x2 is 1, then the output of y will be 1. Then the output of y will be 1. So that we need to implement. That we need to be implement. So logical functions of OR gate that have been actually described or is actually placed here. Okay. So means then there is some weightage value is actually given that x1, 1 and x2 is 1. So considering to that, if our value, so it is our weightage value, right? So suppose forget about this x0. Forget about this x0 is -1. Okay. x1 and x2. In the first case, x1, if the value of x1 is 0 and x2 value is 0. So what will be value? So as per the formula, what is the formula? The formula is x1 W1 plus X2 W2. Okay. So if the value of X1, so what is the value of X1 in the first case? That is the 0. So 0 and weightage of for that particular X1, that is 1. So 0 into 1 means the value will be 0. And in the case of X2, the value is 0. So 0 into 1, that is also 0. 0 into 1, that is also 0. So 0 plus 0, that is the value means 0. So in the case of y, the value will be 0. Means it is following the particular condition, whatever the truth table is actually saying, that value of x1 and x2 is 0, then the output will be 0. So if we are implementing that, so if the value of x1, w1 plus x2, w2, x1 is 0, w1 is 1, and x2 is 0 and w2 is 0, then x1, x2 and that have been implemented, and if the value is actually produced, then the output will be 0. Now, you people can say that why we are considering this 1 and here will be 1. Okay. So, behind it is, I am not like similar like that. We can implement 1 here easily. Okay. It is actually showing 1 here, right? But in the case of this 1, behind the reason of this 1, that have a mathematical implementation. Okay. We need to adjust it. So, as I said, looking or discussing this thing is very easy, but while implementing this, while doing the things in mathematically, it is very tough. Okay, means 1 is written here in both of the cases, x1 and x2, the 1 is written here, but it is not like that I want to put 1 here and I can put 1. We need to adjust this particular value. We need to point up this particular value. We need to take the weightage of w from starting to 0. We need to take the W. We need to take the weightage value of W from initially to 0, or we can take initially to from -1 also. So we need to check that at which particular level, at which particular weightage, the value is getting adjusted, or we can implement this condition that if x1 and x2 is 0, then the y will be 0. So we need to adjust this. So starting, forget about this W1 is 1 and W2 is 1. Okay, we need to implement. So first we need to check W1 is 0, right? First we need to take W1 is 0. So what I'm trying to say is that first we need to take W1 as a value of 0. So if we are taking the value W1 is 0, then what can be? And also similarly, if we are taking the value of W2 is 0, then what it can be? So suppose if the value of W1 is 0 and W2 is 0, right? So now put the value of X1 and X2. So value of X1 is 0 and X2 value is 0. So if we are following the condition X1, W1, and while the value of W1 is 0, so X1 and W1 produce the result of 0 and X2 into W2 produce the result of 0. So 0 plus 0, it will be 0. So for the first one, for the first case, case number one, if x1 and x2 is 0, then the output of y will be 0. It is satisfying the condition, right? Now, for the second case, if x1 is 0 and x2 is 1, now put the value x1, w1 is 0. 0 into 0, that is 0. And x2, w2, that is 0 into 1, also 0. So 0 plus 0, that is 0. So if it is satisfying, so in that particular case, the test case is not satisfying. Means if one of the input is 1, then the output will be 1. But while the W1 and W2 is value of zero. So it is not actually satisfying the condition. So we need to adjust again. Whatever the weightage we are going to take, whatever the weightage we are going to take here, it will be same for all the cases. It will be same for all the cases. We cannot change the value or change the weight in every case. So while creating the odd table, while if we are trying to implementing this odd table, we, if we are taking a value of W at one point, so the value of W is should be, we need to consider for each of the cases. So the value of W, so the value of this W need to same for all the cases, need to same for all the four test cases, need to same for all the four test cases. So here the W1 zero, if the weightage, if the weight of W1 and W2 is zero, then it is not satisfying the condition. It is not actually implementing the odd table. So now we need to move or we need to adjust this particular weightage. So similar for the next value, we need to take suppose 0.1. Okay, so we need to check for each of the particular point that at which particular point this particular value is satisfying. Okay, so for that there is a large we can say a table we can implement where we can, we need to check the value of each W at every point. So these are called epochs. Okay, every one time we are trying to fulfill a condition with the value of weightage. If it is not satisfying, then we are going to move for the next. So that will be an epoch, right? So it is called as epoch. So W1, W2, whatever the things are, we need to check the value. It is not like that I have written one that can be put as one, or I can put one anywhere. This is the logic that this one I am getting by adjusting the value of weightage, by adjusting the value of weightage. Okay, so this weightage value of this one and one, we are getting, we are doing a mathematical calculation behind this, and then we are getting that if the value of weight of one and W2, if the weightages are one and one in both the cases, then the odd table condition can be implemented or it can be done. So first of all, we have taken the value of W1 as zero. Now it is not satisfying. So in the next case, we are going to move just a little bit high, not a total high. Okay. So in the next case, we can move to W1 as 0.1 and similarly W2 as 0.1. Then we are going to again test the cases. So in some point, maybe it is not satisfying, or in some point it is satisfying. So again, we are getting some particular value. If it is satisfying, then we can say yes, at the particular point of W1 and W2, if the value is 0.1, then it can, then the condition is satisfying, right? So we need to adjust. Okay, now here, what we can do, we can identify that at which range we can have a particular range, keeping in mind that at which particular range the value of weightage can be. Okay, so if it is not satisfying in the case of zero, so first what we can do, we can take a value of one. We can, it is, as it is very easy, the OR gate implementation is very easy. So we can, first we need to identify the range. So we are taking the value of zero, so it is not actually getting. So we are putting the value of W1 as one and W2 as zero, okay, or W2 as one. So it is depending on the person who is actually doing the mathematical expression or mathematical calculation. If I am doing, I can go W1 for one, W2 is zero, and then I am going to check again. For any person X, he or she can put the value of W1 and W2 one in the same time and check the value. So if the case of W1, W2 is satisfying with the value of one, then okay, fine. So I have the answer. Okay, here my value or my odd table, whatever the things, whatever the gate I'm trying to implement, this gate is actually implemented. So the value of the weightage W1 and W2, one here in this particular scenario, the W1 and W2 will be one. Okay, similarly, so this is how, means what I'm trying to explain, that the weightage that have been mentioned here, this one and one, it is not, I want to put one, so that's why I'm trying to put one. No, it is not like that. It is some calculation behind that, that we need to calculate. We need to calculate the weightage value. We need to calculate this weightage value. Any doubts here? Whatever I'm trying to say, if any doubts is here.
सर W का जो वैल्यू लेंगे वो मतलब आउटपुट के अकॉर्डिंग लेंगे कि मेरा आउटपुट किस तरह से आएगा, मतलब W के वैल्यू पर ही मेरा आउटपुट मतलब ये होगा ना,
यस
क्योंकि हम लोग स्टार्टिंग में जीरो लिए थे तो सारे जीरो आ जाएगा, जब हम लोग वन लिए तब हम लोग का जीरो का भी आउटपुट वाला वो सेटिस्फाइड हो गया और वन वाला भी।
यस एक्चुअली देखो, अगर मैं तुम्हें बता रहा हूँ कि एक और टेबल को मीन्स एक और गेट को इम्प्लीमेंट करो यूजिंग मैक्लोपिट्स न्यूरन, राइट? तो मैक्लोपिट्स न्यूरन तुमको पता है और गेट तुमको पता है, तो अब इम्प्लीमेंटेशन कैसे होगा? हमको क्या इम्प्लीमेंट करना है? और गेट। तो और गेट का जो ये ट्रूथ टेबल है इसको इम्प्लीमेंट करना है। तो इम्प्लीमेंट क्या कैसे होगा? मेरा जो इनपुट वैल्यू है दैट इज X1 एंड X2, मेरा इनपुट वैल्यू के हिसाब से मेरा आउटपुट वैल्यू यही आना चाहिए, क्योंकि और गेट का ट्रूथ टेबल पहले से डिफाइंड है, हम लोग उसको बस इम्प्लीमेंट करना चाहते हैं। तो हम लोग को जो भी इनपुट होगा अकॉर्डिंग टू X1 एंड X2, द वाई वैल्यू शुड बी सेम। तो दिस वाई वैल्यू वी नीड टू फाइंड आउट। इफ द वैल्यू ऑफ X1 एंड X2 जीरो एंड वन, देन द आउटपुट ऑफ वाई दैट विल बी वन, दैट वी नीड टू इम्प्लीमेंट। तो एज पर दैट सीनारियो वी नीड टू चेंज और वी नीड टू एडजस्ट आवर वेटेज वैल्यू।
ठीक
ओके
है
ओके फाइन। तो दिस इज द बेसिक सिंपल ऑफ ऑर गेट। ऑर गेट इज वेरी इजी। लुक इन द नेक्स्ट, देयर इज एन गिवन एंड गेट। देयर इज अ गिवन सिनेरियो दैट इज एंड गेट। तो एज आई हैव डिस्क्राइब द प्रोसेस ऑफ ऑर गेट, एज आई हैव डिस्क्राइब द टोटल प्रोसेस ऑफ ऑर गेट, हाउ द थिंग्स एक्चुअली डन इन ऑर गेट, सो नाउ आई वुड लाइक यू पीपल टू इम्प्लीमेंट दिस एंड गेट। I would like you people to implement this AND gate. What to implement? That what will be the weightage value? I just want to get the weightage value. That what will be the weightage value of W1 and W2 in the case of AND gate? I have shown you that how to calculate the value of weightages in the OR gate. So now you people calculate the value of AND gate. What will be the weightage value of AND gate in the case of if I am using the Maclopit's neuron with respect to AND gate? Then what will be the weightage value? So it, I think it will not take much time. So I will give you 5 minutes. It will be enough to find out the weightage of AND gate. 5 minutes also not needed. So just quickly try to find out the weightage of AND gate. What will be the weightage of AND in the case of AND gate? What will be the weightage in the case of AND gate? Quickly. So if the value is calculated, what is the value of weightage value of this AND gate? What
सर
is
इसमें भी शायद वन ही होगा,
means W1 और W2 क्या क्या होगा? what will be the weightage of W1 and W2 in the case of AND gate? How we can calculate, or anyone, what will be the value of W1, W2? Anyone? वैल्यू ऑफ डब्ल्यू वन एंड डब्ल्यू टू क्या होगा? किसी को रिजल्ट आया W1 W2 का? ओके, सो हियर इन द केस ऑफ एंड गेट ऑल्सो द W1 एंड W2 इज 1. इन द केस ऑफ हियर ऑल्सो इन द केस ऑफ एंड गेट द W1 एंड W2 विल बी 1. W1 and W2 will also be 1. Now put the values of X1 and X2 with respect to position and calculate the weightage with multiplication of the weightage, calculate the value, then we will get the result as per the AND gate. Okay, so here in the case of AND gate, if all the values are high, then the result will be high. Otherwise, all the things are low voltages we can consider. So if any one of the value is 0, then it will be 0 in the output section. And if all the things are all the values are 1, then it will be considered as 1, right? So implementing these values, so suppose 0 and 0 here in the first case, so 0 x1 and x2, so x1 is 0, so 0 into 1 0, and x2 is 0 into 1, that is 0, so output will be 0. So in the case number 2, x1 is 0, so here it is 0 into 1 0, and x2 is 1, so 1 into 1 1, so 0 plus, so that will be considered as 0. So these are some examples that have been given that we can also actually do many such kind of things with this Maclopitz neuron. We can train some Maclopitz neuron to recognize number from 0 to 1. Means, and it is actually some pattern recognition problem. It is a pattern recognition problem that if I want to recognize a pattern that where it is a 3 or not. So we can also train some Maclopitz neuron to use some pattern recognition. So what is the number? We can also try to recognize that. Here, now the thing is that network of this Maclopitz neuron. So, in the case of Maclopitz neuron, multiple inputs are there. So, one neuron cannot do much on its own, right? So, we have given many inputs needed to produce this. So, many input is needed there for producing this particular output. So, many inputs is coming and some neuron that is called the neuron part. Summation of all the values, then some input or the sigma values or the threshold function is given, and with respect to that, then the output. So, if I am saying about considered a biological scenario, biological neuron scenario, so what happens that neuron and synapses, that neurons, all the neurons are connected with each other, and the flow or the response is actually processed or flowing inside our body. So, similar to like that. It is neuron 1, we can consider there is neuron 2, then there is neuron 3 up to dot on neuron n number of neurons are connected with each other. So, and the input of the next neuron, the input of the second neuron will be the output of the first neuron, will be the output of the first neuron. So, in the case of second neuron, with the case of second neuron, that is neuron j, the input that is in ij is the output of the previous neuron, is the output of the previous neuron, that is output of Wij, that is output of Wij. So as I said initially that this is a concept of similarly like our biological neuron model that all the neurons are connected to each other. Here also same things, that the flow of the process is going to pass from each neuron to another neuron. And if from the second neuron, the input will be the output of the previous neuron. From the second neuron, the input will be of the previous neuron. And here in the case of this particularly neurons, inputs and output section, the threshold limit, the values, what everything is present there. Also in some advanced stages when we are going to deal with, we are getting many hidden layers, hidden neuron layers that have so many functions implemented, and calculation part is needed. So much the number of hidden neurons is high. So when the number of hidden neurons are high, then the output or then the calculation or the prediction will be much appropriate or much accurate, we can say. Okay, so if the number of hidden neurons is much high, then the output will be predicted will be much better actually. Okay, then another topic, it is the perceptron. So we are not going to start today about this topic of perceptron. So we have talked on the topic of this macropitch neuron and all of this particular thing, how we have seen that how to calculate the weightage value and all of this particular scenario. So this is not actually present in your syllabuses. As I said, that syllabus, whatever the things are present in your syllabus, that is actually not too much. All the things have been touched with the basics, that what is the scenario, what is the basic of each of the things. So module 1, module 2 and module 3, that have been discussed. All of the most of the topics have been discussed and we have done. And for the topic of module 4, that is totally on the practical base, that is anaconda installation process. I don't need to discuss on this anaconda installation process, because all of you have already installed anaconda, most of you, because we are doing the practical classes for the long time. So installation process, that is not I am going to discuss on that. Okay, so data types with Python, basic operation setup, these all also have been done. So we are going to do something on NumPy. Okay, so mathematical functions of NumPy, SciPy, SciPy packages are there, data frame and operators, data visualization using matplotlib. So we are going to do some data visualization using some matplotlib function. So in one class, I think I have already shown you people that how to implement this matplotlib function in the Python, in the Anaconda. We are giving the x value of xy, we are labeling all of the things, and then all the things have been put in here. Okay, so up to this we have discussed today, and time is going to end today. Okay, so I am not going to actually take it much high because it will be disconnected. So this is for all for the today's class. So thank you all for joining into the session, and stay safe, take care.
Thank you, sir.